Hello everybody, this is Jeff from the Front Range Community College Library. We're going to talk today about how to use the database ProQuest. So I'm starting from the Front Range homepage here. I'm going to go to the library website first. So we click Academics, then Libraries. Then I'm going to scroll down a little bit and choose the right library, Boulder County Campus. And we're going to scroll down a little bit here where you see electronic databases. I'm going to click into ProQuest. That's the first database. And if you're in a class where you're going to write a paper and you have to base it on some kind of professional articles, something published from some sort of professional writer in a professional journal or magazine, this would be a great database to look in. This isn't going to look through the regular internet. It's only going to look through professionally published articles. So you don't waste your time looking for things that aren't going to be acceptable. So let's say you're going to do a paper on the link between autism and vaccines. So type in autism here, and we could just do a search here and see what comes back. I do it one step at a time, my searches. I don't type in all my search terms all at once. I do them one at a time so I can see what's coming back and what's getting eliminated. And you can see we have articles in here, just doing a general search on autism, 11,140 full articles in here. Now that's a lot. That's good. Now we're going to go back and we're going to kind of narrow this down a little bit. So to go back, I click Modify Search. So let's say over here we can limit it. Let's say how about articles where autism is in the title. And just go down here where it says Document Title, TI. Let's redo the search and see how many. So we had over 11,000. So when autism has to be in the title, it takes us down to 7,205, which is pretty good. Let me show you a little trick maybe to get a little bit more. So we have 7,205. There's the thing about that word autism, the articles could be in there under autism, or they could be under autistic or autistics. So as a little trick, we can put a little asterisk there, Shift 8. After the S, because after the S, if it's autistic, there would be a T next. If it was autism, then M would be next. So if we do that, it's going to hit all versions of that word. And I don't want to miss out on an article just because it's a different version of the word than I had typed in. Let's do a search there. So we got a few more articles there. We had 7,200. So when I changed it to the asterisk, we have 8,004 articles. So there were about 800 articles we were going to miss out on if we didn't do it that way. So let me go back to Modify Search here again. Let's talk about the vaccine issue now. So we've got a good set of autism articles here. Now if I do vaccine, I'm not going to get vaccinate or vaccination or vaccinates or any of that. So why don't I do this? Again with my little trick, I'm going to do, and you don't have to do this, but I like to do it so I can get the kind of the broadest range of articles. So I did right where the spelling would change from vaccinate or vaccine or vaccines or vaccinates or vaccinations, I put in the asterisk so I get all versions of it. And let's do a search here one step at a time. So autism has to be, some version of autism has to be in the title, and then we're just kind of looking to link that up with vaccine. 249 articles. So now we're getting down to a reasonable, manageable level of articles we can look through. I am going to, now let's go back to Modify Search again. What about if vaccine was in the title as well? Document title. Just one step at a time, doing this nice and slow. That takes us down to 165 articles. Now we could start opening articles here, or I'm going to show you some of the things you could do. Sometimes in classes they will say, I only want to see peer-reviewed research. And that means your teacher only wants to see research from higher level research journals. Now you don't have to do this, but if you have that request, that's something we could do pretty easily here. We could click this little peer-reviewed box and we could weed out anything that isn't from a higher level research journal. Okay. So it's looking pretty good here. We now have 40 results. So we started with over 11,000. We have it now narrowed down to 40. Let's take a look here. How about this one here? Let's take a look here. I can open this article up. Now we're looking at the article here. It looks pretty good. I see the authors. I see the title. I see when it was published. Here's the article over here. But let's say you wanted to get a PDF instead of this. I like PDFs because they're in the original format it was published in. If I click full text PDF, it's going to load this article in the original format that it was published in. So there you see it looks like it looked when it was published in print, which I like that. If you want to print it off, you click print here. You can print it off. You could save it by clicking that disk and save it somewhere. You could save it to a folder within this database. You could email it to yourself or email it to your teacher. Let me go back here to the original citation they brought up. So there's all the things we can do with this article. And also there's a function within this database where you can get a citation for this article. Okay, so right up here, if you'll notice, there's a little button that says cite. If we click there, it's going to generate a citation. Now, by default, it's going to generate an MLA citation. We could change that if you wanted to. You could change it to APA if someone asks you for APA or these different types of citation styles. But let's say with that MLA citation, let's just assume you need MLA. You can highlight that text. You could copy it. And you could go into your Works Cited page of your paper. And you could paste that in. So I've got the citation. Now, I have another video where it shows you in depth how to make all these corrections, but really quickly I'm going to show you how to make some corrections to this, because you'll notice it's not quite the same as the other ones. It looks a little bit different. So what we would do is set it to the correct font, Times New Roman, 12 point. I'm going to match up the color to a standard black colored font. There we go. And then if I go into the paragraph button here, I can correct the indentation to be a hanging indent, which is what MLA needs. And double spacing, and don't add extra space. And then I've got a pretty good looking citation there. Just check it over for any errors or capitalization errors. I see an error right there that P on the Mayo Clinic proceedings should be capitalized. Let me fix that. There we go. Otherwise it looks like a pretty good citation. So there's a quick intro on how to do citations. I have a longer video that shows you step by step, a lot slower, how to do that online also. So let me stop there. Let's go back to our results, show you some other things you can do with these searches. So we have all these great searches here. Let's say you wanted to look at certain time periods. It's bringing back the most recently published articles first for you here in your search. But let's say we're looking at this concept of vaccines and autism. How about let's look at some historical research. It shows us all the timelines. Here's all these articles published in 2011. Here's the ones from 2010, 2009. Let's go back and see historically what people were saying about this issue. Let's go back. There's 1999. If we click on the bar for 1999, we can see all the articles published in 1999 on this topic. The thing that's interesting here, you can see people, it's really not a new concept that people are starting. Most scientists and doctors would say that there isn't a link between autism and vaccines. You can see here all the way back in 1999, people were beginning to publish articles saying that there wasn't any evidence for this. So that would be pretty interesting for your paper to show, and you could very easily with this database, you could look historically at that research. If you want to look, we could clear this. We could go back to all of our articles. Once it's cleared, it's going to go back to all those timelines. And you could look at different years, you could look at 2007, and you could just compare these articles year by year, what was happening, and you could kind of trace the history of this controversy. So that's the basics of how to use this database. There are some other options that you can use that are more advanced. I'll show you those in future videos. And if you have any questions, please contact me in the library through email, or call me, or drop by, and I'll help you out with these one-on-one. Also, to log in to these databases from home, you'll need some special login information, which I can provide you with in the library. Thanks a lot for watching. This is Jeff signing off.